variety. So we're going to be installing a project source light, and we're going to use some plastic wire mold, and I'll show you how to put it up. It's very easy. Okay, I mark where I want the switch, so I've got my PVC wire mold like that. Take my knife. Put that off like that. So we'll come out of this out right here. Oh boy, it's nice you don't have a bunch of wires in here. It's going to be easy to work with. And you know what, I must have my regular screwdriver, but I don't. As you know, I do not have it. Well, I do have it. So I break the little tabbies out here. Okay, so that little piece pops out. Let's do this in here like this. And we'll screw this onto the box. Alright, now we can take our, we'll take our cellophane off the back of this here. Set it on the top in the little slot here. Get it straight. Push against the wall so it's nice and flat. Screws. When you can't find something, getting frustrated is not going to help you at all. Ripping out the credit card and buying another one will solve the problem. Shorten this just a little bit. Oh, I don't have my cutters, so I'm going to do it this way. Break out. I'm going to use these two tabbies here, so I'm going to break out this one here. I'm just hoping I get the right one out because my cutters are gone. And if you don't have it, you can't use it. So I was lucky, it broke out the way it should. Let's hope I'm just as lucky breaking out the tabbies for this. But if not, it is what it is. Thank you. Well, fortunately, these were in the car, so I'm glad I didn't lose them. So we'll break out the ones here. Just the end, so if I cut a wire, it'll be where it's on the strip, so it's not going to matter. And we'll get our ground pigtail out of here. So it's easy to control this one. Here in the country I was born in, black is live, white is neutral, and you always switch the live side. Wow, perfectly even, that was nice. Okay, we'll snap our box for you on this. About an inch off the two black wires. Okay. Should have it nice and tight. Straight screwdriver is you better tighten than the Phillips. Okay, you always loop your wires in the direction of the screw changes. Okay, I'll fold the ground wire in on this side of the box, just away from everything. box is deep enough, so I won't worry about the screws hitting the wires. Yeah, I hate how it hops like that. Go to the regular one. Make sure my battery is away from everything. Our other wires are off the way. Okay, so we'll cut the tails from this side in here. The wires in our box are kind of short. But there's nothing I can do about that. Clip it off even with the shortest one here. Now hold my tail down so that it doesn't get moved and twist its way out of the wire. My elbow hurts too much to twist without my pliers. Okay, so here's our ground wire down here at the bottom. Now I'll get our two light wires together here. Crooked, so I'm going to go back to ground zero and just start all over. Make sure I'll clear the bottom. And I'm holding this tail to keep it from twisting and coming out of the twist inside the wire. And I think if that happens, they will be uneven and they won't have a good connection. Get our black wire here. Okay, I'll just make sure that our screws are tight to the box. That one is tight, but that it's the box that's loose. So we'll break out our little tabby here. You'll see the different sizes here for the different size rotor motor we're using. So break these out. Wires out of these holes. So we'll put our white on the silver screw, black on the brass. Silver screw is on the same side as the green screw. Brass is over here. And if you look closely at the brass screw, which is live, you'll notice the slot is narrower for the live. We'll flip it around, put our black on the brass. We'll
Okay. So we can fold, it'll keep our groundwater down at the bottom, we'll go up and down, put the bag in my bag in the box, here, put the groundwater down all the way, and we'll get some screws put in there. I cut this wire short so that, or not the wire, the screw short so I don't hit the wire in the back there. So first we'll hook our groundwire up, got the round solid wire here. Get them even at the end here. Okay, we'll take our black wire, we'll bring our strands up like that, bring them down like that. We'll wrap them around the solid wire like that. We'll put our wire nut on. We'll make sure our insulation goes up into the bottom of the cap. Okay, and we'll do the same with the white wire, bring it up, bring our strands down like that, wrap our strands around the solid wire, make sure they're even like that, put our cap on, and I'll make sure our insulation goes up into the bottom of the wire nut. I'll rip the pliers here, and I'll just make sure it's tight. Okay, now we can go over the wire into the box. Turn this way. We'll tighten our screws here. And make sure that's not hitting the wires. And those aren't hitting the wires. Okay, well, let's make sure no wires are going to be pinched anywhere. Put it back on here like this. Okay, the wires are exposed. We'll put our decorative caps on here. Put our globes on. So our room goes on over like this. And you'll have to fight with it, so I'm not going to do that. No. so we'll screw it all that in. I cut the screws and started them so that I don't have to fight with that on camera. I'll just put a couple of make sure our wires are all in good position there. So I started my nuts on these light gloves so that I wouldn't, in case it got caught, I wouldn't be fighting with it on camera, so we got it done. Alrighty, so that is how to properly install a project source light here from Lowe's. They're not terribly expensive, and using a non-metallic plastic PVC wire mold. It makes it easy to work with. Peace. Thanks for watching.